Explain this analogy you make between the sex instinct and the death instinct.
Professor Freud claims that the sexual drive arises from a simple urge towards pleasure. If he's right, the question is, why is this urge so often successfully repressed?
You used to have a theory involving the impulse towards destruction and self-destruction, losing oneself.
Well, suppose we think of sexuality as fusion, losing oneself, as you say, but losing oneself in the other. In other words, destroying one's own individuality. And wouldn't the ego and self-defense automatically resist that impulse?
You mean for selfish, not for social reasons?
Yes. I'm saying that perhaps true sexuality demands the destruction of the ego.
In other words, the opposite of what Freud proposes.
No. Have you ever made love to a truly great woman?
Actually, my fiance is pretty sexy.
And when you make love to her, you feel true and beautiful passion, and you, for at least that moment, lose your fear of death.
No, that doesn't happen.
I believe that love that is true and real creates a respite from death. All cowardice comes from not loving or not loving well, which is the same thing. And when the man who is brave and true looks death squarely in the face, like some rhino hunters I know, or Belmonte, who's truly brave, it is because they love with sufficient passion to push death out of their minds until it returns as it does to all men. And then you must make really good love again. Think about it.